Hey everybody, today we are going to talk about everybody's favorite subject, buying gear. Look, the reality is that you want to get the most for your money. I want to get the most for my money. I don't want to get ripped off. I want to make sure that the things that I am purchasing are worth every penny. I work a full-time job and I am not a rich person by any means. I have to be very conscious of the money that I'm spending and make sure that my dollar is going as far as it can. And we all know about the rising cost of film photography, blah, blah, blah. We know that it's going up. I'm not here to harp on that. I'm not here to kind of, plead any sort of case regarding the price of film. But what I do want to talk about today is what I think is the best way to get the most value out of a film camera purchase now in 2021 with the state of the market. I recently picked up this camera. This is a Minolta SRT-102, and I also separately got this 55mm f1.7 lens to go with it. I purchased this camera because I didn't have a fully mechanical Minolta camera in my collection. I have a lot of Minolta lenses, and I like the Minolta system, and I really wanted, sort of an insurance policy of having a really robust tank of a camera. And this fits the bill. It's a really beautiful camera. It's really well made. It's really sturdy. The 102, I think, is not quite the highest end of the SRT series, but it is pretty well sought after in regards to the SRT series because it has the mirror lockup. I think the only camera kind of above this one is the 202 series, which has some different features, but it's missing the mirror lockup feature. All in all, I'm very happy with this camera. It feels really good to use, and I'm very excited to put a lot of rolls through it. But the relevant part of this is how I bought this camera, not why I bought this camera. I picked this camera up on Mercari for about $35, knowing that it probably wasn't going to be in functioning order. I was knowingly taking a gamble. But I did this with the intent to have it CLA'd, have it sent out for repair, to get myself a nice, fully functioning, well lubricated, well oiled machine of a camera. And it turns out that I wound up kind of reinforcing an idea that I had previously. If you check out this video up here about why, I think it's so important to get film cameras repaired, I spoke about this being a potential way to get a really good value for your money in terms of getting a film camera. I paid $90 shipped back to me for a CLA service from John Titterington. He does excellent work. The camera is now in beautiful shape. I mean, he cleaned every inch of this thing and it operates wonderfully. I highly recommend him if you're looking for a CLA service for a camera. His pricing is very competitive. So altogether, I paid about $120 for this camera. Now you might think, man, that's kind of expensive. You could pick these cameras up for much, much cheaper. But you have to think of what I got as an end result. For about the same price of picking one up working, I now have a fully serviced camera that's going to be guaranteed to work for a very long time and not need a service for a very long time. If you were to type in Minolta SRT-102 into eBay, you'd kind of see a bit of a variation in pricing, but the idea kind of holds true. The non-working kind of beat-up camera bodies are floating in that $25 to $50 range, and the working bodies are floating in that kind of $100 range. So again, for a little bit of effort, not much more money, still kind of the average going rate for a really nice condition working one, I got a camera that is now cleaned, lubricated, and adjusted and is working flawlessly. There is a big difference between a camera that is working right now and a camera that's recently been serviced. Because when you buy that camera that is currently working, if you don't have a service record, there is nothing indicating that it's going to continue working for a while before it inevitably needs a service, and you're going to wind up spending more in the long run. I mean, obviously, you're going to have to get most of your cameras serviced, and that this camera eventually will need to be serviced again, but I'm spreading out that cost significantly farther down the road than I would be if I had bought a working one for about $80, and then 6 months later, I need to go get it CLA'd, and I'm paying another $90 to get it serviced. And if you do go this route, you get the added benefit. This is something that I mentioned in the video that I linked earlier, that you get to support a camera repair shop. I will say this, I have sent my camera to several different repair shops, and if the price seems too good to be true, it probably is. I've sent my camera to a very popular repair shop and had had nothing but issues, thinking, oh, this price is so great. I'm sure if you're in the film community, you know which place I'm talking about. I'm not going to really put this place on blast, but I've had a lot of, you know, negative experiences with them. But if someone is offering a competitive price for a repair, you know, it's worth giving them your money. You are actively engaging in keeping film alive. A big part of keeping cameras and film cameras going is having access to repair shops. These repair shops are an integral part of the film ecosystem, especially as cameras age. I mean, this camera and cameras like this, I think this is from the late 60s, early 70s, somewhere around there. I have cameras from the 50s. These cameras aren't going to last forever, but if they're maintained, yeah, they will. And we all know how integral, you know, these repair shops are to making sure that happens. And the value is twofold in that sense. You get a really high quality product for your money. You get a camera that is guaranteed to work for a very long time and is going to work properly and precisely. And you get to support a large part of the film ecosystem. I think now in 2021, if you're looking to buy a film camera, if you're a bit more of an informed consumer, if you're looking to really dive into film as a hobby, if you are looking to pick up a second body, especially mechanical body to you know, accompany maybe a point and shoot or something, that this is a route you should highly, highly consider. You're gonna get a lot for your money and you're gonna support the film industry in a really, really good way. I'm gonna put John Titterington's email in the description of this video. If you're looking for a camera repair, I highly recommend him. He was very pleasant to work with. He was very timely and his pricing was very competitive. I really recommend him. He did an absolutely wonderful job on this camera. But there are many, many repair shops out there that are really worth considering and you know, worth giving your money to. And again, I think you put yourself in a really good position when you go this route. And I think, you know, you're going to find that when you start comparing the price of a cheap untested camera plus a CLA to good condition working cameras, you're going to find that you're not spending much more money. If any, you're going to find that the pricing is very competitive. So anyway, yeah, I hope that was informative. I hope that kind of changed your thinking about buying a film camera in 2021. I hope that helped you consider going this route, because again, I think it's really, really good. So that's it. I will see you all next time. Take care. Thank you for watching.